Hello learners, welcome to the NIIS studio. Today we are going to discuss about module 5A, which is management of libraries, and we are going to discuss lesson 16, which is library staff. I am Dr. Priya Rai, deputy librarian from National Law University, Delhi. Well, in the previous chapter we have learned about the library system and management, and in this chapter we learn about library staff. We will try to focus about all the aspects of library staff, the importance of a library staff, and what are the basic skills a library staff should have in a library. So viewers, get ready to learn about what are the important aspects for being a library staff. Human resources are the most vital resource in the library, as all the other resources can be utilized only by the staff of the library. Well-informed library staff is one of the greatest assets of any library. Most of the libraries put lot of efforts into defining the competencies, that is skill, knowledge, attitude and behavior necessary for library staff to provide best services to the users. The staff thus continues the most vital resource of any library. This resource is primarily responsible for transforming all other resources into valuable products and services. So it is therefore necessary to build upon this resource with great care and attention. Different categories of staff at various levels are required to operate several functions of the library. So what we are going to discuss in this lesson, we are going to discuss and we are going to learn the process involved in the building staff strength of a library. So what are the basic involvement or what are the basic things we require to strengthen the library as a staff? Chapter we will learn about the recognition of a staff and information organization as a vital human resource. Presentation will also explain about the requirements of staff in academic, public, special libraries, lists the different categories of library staff and explains their functions. We'll also outline a staff framework on the basis of activities of the library, and it is really very important to discuss the and identify different type of staff requirement for a library. We'll also list various stages of recruitment process. And we will also discuss about and describe the evaluation of staff promotion or performance at all the level. So this is all about the objective we are going to discuss. Now let us discuss about the staffing, employment, skill, jobs. What are the basic things required for staffing? So in the earlier lesson of the module, you have learned the 7 elements of management. Here we'll discuss the staffing, the most important element of management. So staffing includes manpower planning that determines the quality of and quantity of employees of a library. Well, this also exists all level in relation to the size and scale of operation of a library. So the staff of a library is not only a vital resource but also an invaluable asset. So it is the live human resource that uses all other resources optimally to achieve the goals and objective of the library. The performance of a staff is entirely dependent on the quality of the staff. Well, building upon a staff strength is therefore should be given the highest attention. Now let us discuss about the steps involved in staffing. So there are various important steps which are involved in staffing in a library. First and foremost step is the manpower planning. So planning is really very important. We are going to discuss how we'll achieve it. Then another important aspect or segment we can say is the recruitment and the selection. So there are a lot of process of recruitment and selection, and how this has happened we'll discuss. Then employment and induction is really important. We have to explain the staff about their roles and responsibilities. Then once the roles and responsibility has been explained to the staff and they are doing the best way they are serving the users, then performance appraisal is one of the important aspects which is in the staffing or in the library, because only after appraisal they will get motivated and more good work. And then in the last, staff training and development. So these are some of the aspects we are going to discuss about the staffing. Well, it involves a series of steps, as I have already said to you, we'll discuss with as a manpower. First, we'll take a manpower. Manpower planning that determines the quality and the quantity of employees of a library at all the levels in relation to its size and scale of operations. So now discuss in detail about the manpowering. What is a manpowering and how it is important in this segment of staffing? Manpower planning is concerned with the employing persons for performing various activities of library. Its objective are to ensure that the right persons are employed for different positions at the top, middle and the lower level of management. Well, it is really important to find out what person is good in what kind of activities, then only their positions are, you know, are considered. Now, it is therefore necessary to determine the categories of staff and their numbers required at each of the three levels. At each level, functions, duties, responsibilities, authority are the different and varied. So, it varied and they are very different. What kind of functions, what kind of duties and responsibilities and the authority is going to be given to the different staff at different level. So, hence the competent persons with appropriate qualifications and year of various experience should be employed to obtain the best results. Now, the manpower planning, the categories of staff employed for the libraries are, as we have already discussed, top, middle and lower level. So, the categories of staffs are professionals, semi-professionals, non-professionals and supporting staff. Likewise, their qualification, the various categories has been defined. So, their functions, responsibilities and authorities are explained as, we have a top level management where we can say the person is a chief librarian or a deputy librarian. So, these are the top categories. Then, at the top level, qualified library and information professionals are required. So, they are usually professional with good number of experience, good years of experience, and they carry out functions of various roles like responsibilities and the positions of the authority. So, what they are involved in? They are involved in planning, policy and decision making. So, they set procedures and practices of functions and operates, exercise, control and discipline the library. The designation of this level may be vary, but in general, there would be a chief librarian functioning at the top level or a deputy librarian. So, in the middle level, now discuss about the middle level, what kind of designations are being given at the middle level. We have assistant librarian and a senior professional assistants. So, the middle level librarian at the assistant librarian and many of the senior professional assistants, they function. Usually, they take care of the technical activities. They also act as a link between the top and the lower level. So, now discuss about the lower level management. They are basically junior library assistant, which are considered, and the semi-professional assistant. They are doing the lower level management work. Basically, they are junior professional, semi-professional, and they take care of the various routine activities of the library. So, number of professional at the top are few in number. They are very limited, more at the middle level and many at the lower level. So, the number of authorities also, the size and the number of the authority also depend upon the level they are working with. It varies differently. So, this depends on the size of a library in terms of the collection, strength, various activity and number of users. So, on that basis, the staffing, what number of staff is required at the middle level, lower level and top level is decided on the basis of the activities, number of users and the strength of a library. Now, let us discuss about the semi-professional staff in a library. So, semi-professional staff of a library are basically a middle level people, as we have already discussed, and their function is they are engaged in performing library routines and techniques under the guidance of a professional staff, and they are personal with training in library science, usually a diploma or certificate in library and information science along with the other background education qualification. So, their designation may be library assistant, technical or professional assistant, junior cataloger or equivalent. So, they usually perform the routine professional and technical activities. Well, in many libraries, these category of staff work as a support to the professional activities under the direction of the senior professional staff. Now, let us discuss about the non-professional staff in the library. As the top level staff is there, the non-professional staff also work, are very much important and work in coordination with the senior staff. So, non-professional staff are in the library is, as I already said, they are very important and they help in performing various activities to the senior, basically assist their senior library professional staff to do their day-to-day activities. So, non-professional staff may subject to specialist computer hardwares, software technologies and other technical expert appointed for specific purpose for a shorter duration. They may not form part of the regular staff, but they are really very important as completing their day-to-day activities. Their role is advisory and they are not assisted or entrusted with any managerial or routine responsibility. So, they have been given a specific staff, as mentioned, the computer experts are there. Whenever there is a problem in handling the digital library, these staff help the regular professionals in so that their library should work smoothly and conduct smoothly. So, they function under the supervision and the control of a chief librarian and occasionally under deputy librarian. So, they work under chief librarian and deputy librarian, depend on the department sections they serve. Only in large library with number of functions, non-professional staff may be employed permanently. Otherwise, they are made employed on a shift basis. Now, let us discuss about supporting staff in a library. Well, as I already said, that supporting staff are really important and they help in doing and completing their day-to-day activities in a library. So, supporting staff is usually administration and account person who takes care of the office function such as personnel, purchase and store, office maintenance and similar other responsibilities. So, other than the routine work in the library, there are various backhand work which is really important and which need to be done, otherwise the front end activity will be hindered. So, for that the support staff is there who do a lot of important work. So, the staff is also required for cleaning work, sanitation, security, gardening, driving vehicles. These are important functions of the library. The staff has a respective appropriate qualification and experience related to the nature of the work. Now, let us discuss about the recruitment and the selection. So, that was about the staff, the various level of the staffing. Now, we will discuss another important aspect of the lecture is recruitment and selection. Well, recruitment is the second step in the process of building of the staff strength of the library. Well, it covers selection. Well, how selection has been done, personal interview, appointment and induction, roles and responsibility has been explained, then performance appraisal, staff training and development. So, these are some of the aspect of the recruitment of the selection. Now, recruitment and selection, usually the recruitment process starts with advertisement in daily newspaper, employment news publication, professional periodicals and on the internet. So, applications are invited from suitable candidate in a prescribed format. So, at times TV channels, radio broadcasts announce, basically they are made in the newspaper information on jobs and the position for an organization. Well, in general, the application in a prescribed format are required for the sake of convenience of screening and scrutinizing, and usually advertisement seeks data related to the application. So, what it covers? It covers the name, age, contact address, telephone number, email address, ID, Sometimes email ID is important to communicate academic and professional qualification and prescribed years of experience for the post. So these are some of the important aspects for the recruitment and the selection. And another important aspect is advertisement carry the name or designation of the vacant position. It explains the position is vacant and required to be filled. Job description is sometime explained and number of posts, how many posts are there for a particular position, salary, the scales, if it is a government, then the scale is mentioned, and if it is a private, then how much remuneration they are going to pay to the professional staff or the staff of a library is sometime mentions, and the total enumerations, how much money they are going to give. They also mention the terms and condition of the services, last date of the receipt of the application, means what is the date you have to fill the application and submit. After that date, the applications are not considered. So it is important to know what are the last date, and we have to fill the our application as per the prescribed form I have mentioned before the date, last date of the applications. And sometimes career prospects are also indicated. They also mention what are the other prospects of a persons, what they are going to achieve while doing this kind of work, and if they will be recruited in the particular organization. Now, recruitment, under recruitment and selection, registrations by persons seeking jobs in employment exchange for government, private placement services are other means through which person can recruit by organization. So, Library of Academics and Research Institutes finally follow the conventional patterns of recruitment procedure except under special conditions of recruitment for senior positions. So, libraries attached to smaller institutions follow their own respective journal recruitment practices of the parent organization for filing up a position in a library. Public libraries under government follow their usual procedure of recruitment. Now, let us discuss about another important aspect, which is the selection. How the selection procedure is taken care for recruitment of a staff in a library. The selection of a suitable candidate for a specific position in all type of library deals with identifying and matching right application with the requirement of position to be filled. Screening and shortlisting application for personal interview are the next step. So, once the application has been filed, then screening comes. For position at middle and the lower category, written test may be conducted to filter application before making the final list of the person to be called for a personal interview. So, after the screening, they call you for the personal interview. So, what is personal interview? Well, as per my personal experience, this is really very important to explain about yourself in a very good manner. Otherwise, they will reject you, and this gives a very good impact. So, how it deals with? Personal interview, the candidate who are shortlisted are called for interview to assess their personality in various terms to ensure the candidate's suitability for the position. So, they should have an attitude and the aptitude, with they should have a right approach, and one of the important aspect is the communication skills. The communication skills should be very good, and the behavior also, how the candidate are approaching towards the people who are taking the interview and how they are answering. This is their behavior aspect is also seen, and other traits are important to discuss. So, personal interviews for senior level positions, beside qualification, the candidate is judged on the basis of individual ability to lead, take decisions and work in coordination with the junior staff. For the top position, that is to the head, the library candidates at the times are required to make an oral or a formal presentation on a topic of a current interest. So, they have to explain what future aspect they have think for the development of the library. Now, let us discuss about the appointment and the induction, how the appointment and induction of a library takes place. Well, selected candidates are issued appointment letter according to their placement in a selected panel with all terms and conditions of employment. The next important aspect is to take or make an appointment. candidate feel that he or she has joined the right organization. This is really very important. Well, this is a termed as the induction, which refers to inducting the candidate into the organization that he or she has joined. So after joining, they have been explained about the different different sections of the library and different what kind of material are arranged in the library. This is called the induction, and the person is introduced to the other staff members at various level. This has been done after the appointment, once the person has been selected and joined the organization. Then rules and regulation of the organization, that means the duties and the responsibility which a person going to handle, the discipline, and are the aspect that the appointed person should know for the beginning. This induction responsibility is usually assigned to the experienced professional who knows all the aspects of the library and have a good experience working in that sector at middle level to make the new employee feel at home and a new organization. Well, it also include orientation of a new entrants is required, not only to the immediate environment but also to the whole organization's activity, functions and their culture. This is how orientation has been done. So now let us discuss what we have learned in this chapter. What we have learned: the staff of an information organization is a vital human resource. Requirement of staff in academic, public and special libraries. We have also learned the categories of library staff and their functions. We learned the staffing framework on the basis of the activities of the libraries, and also the different type of staff required for the libraries, various stages of recruitment processes and evaluation of staff performance at all the level. Thank you so much.